In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
May the grace and peace of the Lord be with you all.
Amen.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Today we celebrate the life and ministry of St. Camillus. Camillus lived in the latter part of the 16th century into the 17th century. He was a soldier in the Italian army, and he had a problem with the enemy. So he eventually had a conversion experience that led him to study for the priesthood and was ordained. He's famous for forming a religious community to care for the sick and the dying, especially during the plague. They wore a rather distinctive habit. It's a black habit with a red cross right above the left side of the chest, so they were easily identifiable. The next time you visit someone in the hospital, you may notice that nursing or doctors would wear these yellow gowns and gloves and masks. Well, Camillus was the first one to isolate patients to keep other patients safe from contracting infections or the plague itself. And having been a recipient of special diet as a patient, he's the one that's responsible for creating those dietary meals for patients. So let's all keep in mind those who are caring for the sick in our hospital institutions. Let's also pray for new interns, new medical students who are getting acclimated to all these different types of policies and regulations, particularly with regards to isolation of patients. And so we thank God for the start of this ministry, but we also pray for the healing of those who are sick. Lord Jesus, you heal the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgave sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ.
Lord Jesus, you gave yourself to heal us and to bring us strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who adorned the priest, St. Camillus, with a singular grace of charity towards the sick, pour out upon us, by his merits, a spirit of love for you, so that, serving you and our neighbor, we may, at the hour of our death, pass safely over to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. Moses, hearing the voice of the Lord from the burning bush, said to him, "When I go to the children of Israel and say to them, 'The God of your fathers has sent me to you,' if they ask me, 'What is his name?' what am I to tell them?" God replied, "I am who am." Then he added, "This is what you shall tell the children of Israel: I am sent me to you." God spoke further to Moses, "Thus shall you say to the children of Israel: The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name forever. This is my title for all generations. Go and assemble the elders of Israel and tell them: The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, has appeared to me and said, 'I am concerned about you and about the way you are being treated in Egypt. So I have decided to lead you up sites, a land flowing with milk and honey. Thus they will heed your message. Then you and the elders of Israel shall go to the king of Egypt and say to him, the Lord, the God of the Hebrews, has sent us word. Permit us then to go a 3 days' journey in the desert, that we may offer sacrifice to the Lord our God. Yet I know that the king of Egypt will not allow you to go unless he is forced. I will stretch out my hand, therefore, and smite Egypt by doing all kinds of wondrous deeds there. After that, he will send you away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, invoke his name, make known among the nations his deeds. Recall the wondrous deeds that he has wrought, his portents and the judgments he has uttered.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
He remembers forever his covenant, which he made binding for 1,000 generations, which he entered into with Abraham and by his oath to Isaac.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
He greatly increased his people and made them stronger than their foes, whose hearts he changed so that they hated his people and dealt deceitfully with his servants.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
He sent Moses, his servant, Aaron, who he had chosen. They wrought his signs among them and wonders in the land of Canaan.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said, come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I forgot to tell you the name of the religious community that Camillus founded. It's about 5 words long, but they're known as the Camillians, not to be confused with that little lizard that changes its colors. When we say that someone is humble, we kind of mean it as a compliment, but a rather dismissive one. Oh, she's very humble means that she's quiet, that she doesn't make waves, she avoids the spotlight. It can also assure everyone that she's no threat to our ambitions or an easy mark for an aggressive sales pitch. To call something humble, like a humble dwelling, is often shorthand for uncomfortable and boring. And true humility is often equated with humiliation. He can use a few tablespoons of humility. It is more of a warning than advice. But that's not what true humility is. The word humility, like the word human, comes from the Latin word humus, meaning earth. Humility, then, means to be grounded in the truth that we are human, that we're not God. Humility is to recognize that we are not the source of all good. God is. The good that we have, even the good that we do, is from God. The opposite of humility, then, is not pride, but ingratitude. The truly humble individual recognizes the humus, the share with all of God's children, that their hopes and dreams and wants and needs are as important and as worthy as theirs. Jesus calls us not to deny our humanity, but to let go of our attempts to always be right, always in control, always strong, always self-sufficient. Humility is not putting ourselves down, but lifting others up. And so our hands need to be open enough to receive whatever God gives us. Humility means recognizing that we are the hand, not what it holds. Turning to the God who is concerned with our needs, we offer these prayers with firm hope that Christ draws near to carry our burdens with us. For all leaders in the church, may Christ carry them as they bear the responsibility of shepherding God's people. We pray to the Lord. For world leaders, may God give them the wisdom and the strength to combat slavery and oppression of every type. We pray to the Lord. For all workers, for those in search of employment, and for those who are underemployed, may God ease their burdens and may they know God's presence in their toil. We pray to the Lord. For those gathered here, may God's comfort and help lead us to greater truth and to draw nearer to Christ. We pray to the Lord. For those whipped eye, especially those from this excessive heat, may they rest in eternal peace with God in heaven. We pray to the Lord. For Ruth DeLorenzo, for whom we remember especially at this Mass, and for what or for whom do we pray for today? Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Okay, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God. May these offerings of our service placed on your altar in commemoration of Saint Camillus be acceptable to you, O Lord, we pray, and grant that, released from earthly attachments, we may have our riches in you alone, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just. It is our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promised in the new world to come. And so, holy angels and saints, we praise you forever. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, said a blessing, he broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, your people spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Bishop, and all the clergy and religious. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the martyrs, Saint Camillus, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Pray the words that Jesus once prayed. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress and anxiety, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith and courage of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen.
The blood of Christ. Amen.
St. Camillus, to seek you always above all things, and to bear in this world the likeness of Christ, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.